In this video, we're going to take an opportunity to explore how to create a class project using AWS Cloud9. AWS Cloud9 is a cloud-based IDE, a place where you can write, run, and debug your code with just a browser. Browser-based IDEs are great for classroom use because it avoids having students maintain their own computer environments. The code can run on one student's Cloud9 browser session, it'll run for all your other students' browser sessions. You won't hear the dreaded, "It works on their computer but not on my computer." Cloud9 also has many other features, such as the ability to allow your students to pair program together in real time on separate computers. This module will cover GitHub Classroom from the teacher perspective, and then from there we'll transition to the student perspective of accepting an assignment. From here we'll exclusively follow the student as they progress through their assignment on AWS Educate. They'll log in to AWS Educate, go to their classroom, and eventually move to AWS Cloud9, where they'll work on their project. After they've finished, they'll go ahead and upload their code onto GitHub so that a teacher can review. To begin, let's start within the GitHub Classroom dashboard. So here I have my dashboard with my course, Algorithmic Game Theory, and I want to create a new assignment. I'm creating my first assignment, and I want it to be an individual assignment. Here, I can start and just build out my assignment with my name. I already have debug C# tic-tac-toe utilizing Minimax algorithm. And I want to make this private. And as I go through, I want to enable assignment invitation URL so my students can create the assignment using the URL. And I want to use starter code. In this case, I know exactly where the starter code is within my GitHub repository. It's going to be Eric DiRosato, C#, tic-tac-toe, C#. Let's go ahead and set a deadline. In this case, I'm going to give the students about a week to do this. Excellent. I'll go ahead and create the assignment. Great. Now, so far, I only have one student that I've listed within my class, and I have Eric DiRosato, student. The next thing I want to do is copy my invitation link and share it with my students. Once the students have this invitation link, they can accept their assignment and a repository will be created for them. Now let's take an opportunity to look at the student perspective. So here we are within the student dashboard for Eric DiRosato's student. He's taken the link that I provided, the invitation link, and now he can accept the assignment. Click accept, and here the repository will be created and all the starter code will be imported. Once everything is done, the assignment has been accepted and the student can now go directly to the repository with this link. Here, all of the starter code is now within the repository, as well as instructions that I provide to my students on how to go about the project. From the student perspective, now that I have the repository, I'm going to go ahead and read through the instructions. And with the instructions, I also notice that there's a setup. And within number one of the setup, it says, go ahead and log into your AWS Educate. This is what you'd like to do with your students, be able to provide the direct link to the AWS Educate sign-in. Here, once I'm at the sign-in page, I can go ahead and put in my credentials, sign in. And as a student, I'm greeted here at the AWS Educate dashboard. And what I'd like to do is go to My Classrooms. Now, as the educator, you should have created a classroom and invited your students. I have a GitHub Education Campus Advisor Program classroom. I'm going to go ahead and click on that. Hit continue. As the student, I'm now greeted with a classroom account page. And here, students can gain access into the AWS services that are provided to them.
They can do this specifically by clicking the AWS console button here. Once a student has access to the AWS Management Console,
they can use any of the AWS services available to them. As my assignment mentions, I want them to use Cloud9. So they can either search for Cloud9, or since it was recently visited, they can just go directly to Cloud9 here. For the sake of exposure and allowing you the opportunity to troubleshoot with your students, I'm going to show you how I went about creating an environment. I'm going to click on Create Environment, and my student can provide a name for the environment. I'm just going to call it debug C# tic-tac-toe, and I'll hit next. Now, in my instructions, I mentioned to my students that they should go with all of the defaults. So open Cloud9, create a Cloud9 environment, name it, keep all the defaults in the within the configuration settings. So they can skip through all this, and you can change this to however you like. In this case, I want to use the Amazon Linux platform so that my students can follow the exact same instructions. I'll hit next. And then from here, I'll just go ahead and create the environment. After the environment's created, students now have access to the IDE. Below, they have access to the command line, and to the left, they have a list of directories. We only have the individual directory that was created for this particular assignment. Now, the beauty of this is that students now can build an environment that looks similar to their peers as well as their teacher. I provided, with the directions, specific instructions on how to go about the setup to create this environment. We're using .NET, C#, so I need them to create a .NET environment. So I provided specific instructions on how to go about building that environment. For this example, I've already done steps 1-8. Now I just need my students to go ahead and clone their repository into their Cloud9 environment. I can just do git clone. Now you'll notice that I had to go ahead and put in a username and password for my GitHub account. Now, given that this environment runs on a machine within the cloud, you can treat it just like a local machine. If you wanted to, you can generate an SSH key so you can have direct access to your GitHub account. You'll now notice that a directory has been created with the source code from the repository. Now students can go ahead and make any of the changes that they need to within the project and continue to utilize the command line in order to interact with their Git repository. Let's say that I've made the changes that I believe are the issue for the project. Now I can go through my instructions and I'm given information on how to go about running the project if I wanted to actually run it within the command line. In this case, I have a command line based game of tic-tac-toe. So I'm going to take this over to my environment. I'm going to CD directly into code and I'm going to go ahead and run. Okay, so the prompt is asking me to pick a board size. I'm just going to do a 3x3. And I'm going to choose a marker X. Computer's going to be O. And I can go ahead and play my game. In this case, it works just fine. I can ensure that the computer wins. Great. Everything seems to work. I can also look at the instructions and run some tests that maybe my teacher has provided for me to ensure that I have met all the requirements. I'll run my tests. Excellent. All my tests have passed. Total test 100. All of them passed 100. No fails, no skips. Great. Now let's say as a student, I found the bug and made the fix. Following kind of best practices of workflow, I'm using another branch here. I created a branch called debug tic-tac-toe. I'm going to check the status. Great, I have my change there that I want to commit, so I'm going to add it, and I'm going to commit with a message, add fix for bug. Great, excellent. So now I'm just going to go ahead and push specifically to this branch, debug tic-tac-toe. Great. So I had to put in my username and password, and it looks like everything went well, and I went ahead and pushed my branch. So if I go here as a student, I can
create a pull request for my instructor. So GitHub already notices that I have the debug tic-tac-toe branch there. Create new pull request. And I'm interested in merging my branch with the bug fixes into master. So I can go ahead and create the pull requests. Add fix for bug. I can, if my teacher is a collaborator, I can go ahead and add them as a reviewer. I'm just going to go ahead and create the pull request. Great. So now my teacher can come in and check my work using the files changed here and provide me some feedback about my work.
We were able to create an assignment in GitHub Classroom and provide instructions to our students on how we want them to complete assignments using the AWS Cloud9 IDE. We spent a majority of the video in the perspective of the student so that you, as the educator, can teach your students how to effectively navigate AWS Educate and AWS Cloud9 to complete an assignment. Remember that the benefit of using a browser-based IDE like Cloud9 is so that you can standardize the student experience by providing instructions on how to build the environment and avoid issues that students might have by using their personal computer environments.